In this animation, the three grids portray plate interaction and deformation in three zones of a subduction region, which include the lock zone at the leading edge of the overlying plate, a transitional zone that locks for approximately 14 months at a time, then slips back a little before continuing its push inland, and the zone far inland from the locked portion of the plates that sees little to no deformation. The grids below each GPS receiver represent compressional stress on that region. The first graph shows the leading edge of the continental plate is locked with the subducting slab, thus gets shortened, building elastic potential energy. The graph shows steady rate of change as the land is being forced relentlessly inland. It will ultimately release the built-up strain, resulting in a great earthquake. Graph 2 shows the land being forced inland due to friction between the plates, but it occasionally backslides along the plate boundary, releasing some of its stored elastic energy in mild seismic tremors spread over a period of days to weeks. The sawtooth pattern on the graph reflects the forward-backward motion of the GPS station on the surface. The third station does not move, and the grid shows no deformation, so the graph is flat.